If I had free will now, I'd add Mark in and say to him, you know, by the end of the next charter, the BBC as we know it ends. And I want the vision. I want a new vision. That means that the BBC is there as a platform for all of the public services to actually use for exhibition. Go and find out and tell me how to do that. And I think that's the best way. Then the next thing is that ask your staff what they really would like to do. You know? And do they want to stay in the BBC because simply they want to be in telly and they want to be rich and perhaps they want to be famous, preferably both? Well, if they do, tell them to start working in commercial television. You know? And inject the word vocation. When I was giving those speeches 10, 15 years ago, I used to talk about public service broadcasting. I think we now need to just drop the broadcast a bit and decide what we mean by public service. And I'm also chair of National Museum of Liverpool. And when I sit now and I listen to people in the museums and library world, when I listen to people in English Heritage, and I look at the salaries they're on and I see what they're doing, you know, that's what I would actually be asking of my director general to be. And as I say to my director general, as Stuart Cosgrove said the other week, actually, how do you justify that someone on television, like Stuart said, he's finding it hard to rationalise his salary against the First Minister of Scotland. And I asked the DG too, why should he be paid over six times more than the Prime Minister? And that's the agenda I would set, and I'd give him 3 weeks to come back with the answers.